Factor common factors and grouping. Grouping. So sometimes when we go to find our GCF, we're going to see that we can't actually pull something out of the entire expression. In that case, it's often helpful to use a trick called grouping. When we're dealing with grouping, we want to find the GCF of the left half of the expression, and the right-hand half of the expression. So once we've done that, we can then factor out the binomial GCF if it matches. So this is an especially good trick when we're dealing with expressions that have four different terms. So when you see an expression that has four different terms, you should start thinking, I'm probably going to have to do some factoring by grouping. So let's go ahead and take a look at this first example. 15xy plus 10y minus 18x minus 12. So I'm not seeing anything that can divide into all of these. They don't have any variables in common. They're not all even. Not all multiples of 3. So it looks like we're definitely going to have to try breaking this in half, see if we can find a common factor on the left-hand side, and then a common factor on the right-hand side. So I just drew this line right down the middle between the terms. And on the left-hand side, I'm now starting to see a pattern. I'm starting to see something they have in common. These are both multiples of 5. So I'll go ahead and pull out a 5. And then I'm also seeing that they have a y in common, so I'll pull out that y. That'll be our GCF. And then what is left? So in this first term, we've got 3x. And in this second term, we'll be left with just a 2, because the y completely divides out. Now on the right-hand side, when I look at this, I'm going to notice that I've got a negative in both of these terms. And even if we had just a negative on the first term, it could be a good idea to divide out a negative, but especially when you've got it in both of these. I'm like, yeah, I can pull a negative number out of both terms. So I'm going to put a negative sign right here. And I'm also seeing that these are both multiples of 6. But they don't have any variables in common, so 6 will just be our GCF. So then we want to figure out what's left. So negative 18x divided by negative 6 will leave us with a positive 3x. And then negative 12 divided by negative 6 will leave us with a positive 2. So when we're dividing out a negative, that's going to change the signs for what is left inside our leftovers, inside the parentheses. Okay, so now our instructions tell us then factor out the binomial GCF. So let's look at the expression as a whole again. So now we've got a 3x plus 2 on the left-hand side and a 3x plus 2 on the right-hand side. So since these two match, we can now pull it out of both sides of the equation, or of the expression. So now we've got 3x plus 2. Put that in parentheses, and then we'll start a new parentheses for what is left over. We've got 5y minus 6. And there you have it. So we've now successfully factored this expression. We have a product of two different things multiplied together. 3x plus 2 times 5y minus 6. And we can actually check and see whether this gives us the original expression using FOIL. So remember that when we FOIL, we want to multiply the first things together. First, outside, inside, and last. Okay, so when we multiply the first things together, we get 15xy. Outsides together, we'll get minus 18x. Insides together, 2 times 5y is plus 10y. And the last ones, 10 times negative 6, careful with the negative signs, will leave us with minus 12. Okay, so that looks like it's the same as our original expression. The terms are just in a different order. We've got negative 18x and then plus 10y. And that's just fine, because if we had 2 plus 3, it'd be the same thing as 3 plus 2. We can add in any order. So this is giving us the same expression as our original. So let's go ahead now to example number 2, and we'll try to factor this one by grouping. Okay, so the first thing that we want to do is recognize that there's no common factor in all of these. So we're going to have to draw a line down the middle. So, on our left-hand side, I'm seeing that there's a 3 in common, and there's an x in common. And then we're left with 2x plus y. And then on our right-hand side, there's really nothing in common over here. So that's a little bit different, but I could still factor out a 1. So it's important when you come to something you don't see anything in common that you keep going, but we want to try pulling out this 1 so that then we'll have something to compare in the next step. So if you don't see anything that they have in common on just one of the sides, go ahead and just put a 1. And then we'll divide a 1 out of both of these expressions, and we'll be left with 2x plus y. So you divide a 1 out of both of these terms, and we're just left with 2x divided by 1 is 2x, y divided by 1 is y. Okay, so now the good news is that we have something matching on both sides here, 2x plus y and 2x plus y. So we can go ahead and pull that out, 2x plus y, put that in parentheses, and then open up a new parentheses for what's left over. Got 3x plus 1. Okay, so again, when we factor, we're just rewriting the expression in a different way as a product of two expressions, and we can check whether or not this is correct by multiplying these two together. So we'll do multiply together the first ones, the outside ones, the inside ones, and the last ones. So we'll get 6x squared plus 2x plus 3xy plus y. Okay, so now if we compare this to our original expression, we've got 6x squared, 2x, 2x, it's a different place, but that's okay. And then we've got 3xy, y, and a y. So these are both matching. So remember that this right here is just a check. We're checking to see whether or not we get the original. But when they ask us to factor, our answer is really this right here, the two different expressions multiplied together. So when someone asks you to factor, this is your final answer, and everything else is just checking to make sure that that answer is correct.